Hi, my name is Isaac Archuleta, and I'm the clinical director at I Am Clinic, which is a mental health practice devoted specifically to the queer community and the religious loved ones. Over the last 12 years, we have had the great fortune of working with mixed orientation marriages. So this is another video in that series. And the topic that I kind of want to talk about today related to this blog is coming out to your spouse. You know, I think that a lot of times we enter marriage thinking that it's the right thing to do. For those of us coming from faith backgrounds or really conservative backgrounds, we think that if we get married to someone of the opposite gender, our heart and our bodies might adjust. We might become accustomed to that and find love. It's really easy, though, to realize, however, that our bodies are pretty steadfast in our sexual orientation. And so coming out is a way of not only being authentic, but it's a way of creating a different future and living, hoping for a different kind of beauty. When we realize that the cravings of our heart and the cravings of our body can produce a really beautiful, painless, even blissful life, coming out within a marriage can be rather momentous. We want to taste a different kind of authenticity, if not actually engaging our sexual orientation, at least being honest within our marriage is a very compelling force. One of the things that might help you come out to your spouse or help you talk about if you have a spouse coming out to you is the difference between sexual orientation and sexual identity. Sexual orientation is the involuntary phenomenon, the involuntary processes of the body. So sexual orientation is not a choice. It is pre-established before we're born by in utero hormone bathings mixed with some other medical components, sometimes genes, other ways that the brain is shaped. There's a whole medical pocket of research that really proves that sexual orientation is established before birth and no factors after birth can change sexual orientation. So sexual orientation in and of itself is the medical, biological experiences, and they're involuntary, they're wired in the body, and it is the orientation, it is the way the body can experience sexual arousal. Sexual orientation is very different than sexual identity. The easy way of thinking about sexual identity is by thinking about it as a name tag. If I walk into a conference and someone hands me a name tag, I can write any name on that. Of course, if I'm being honest, or if it's safe enough, I will put Isaac Archuleta, and then I will wear that identity label on my chest. So sexual identity can have two components, generally speaking. There's the public identity. I am safe enough and confident enough. I am ready enough to present the authentic label. So I'm gonna write bisexual or pansexual on my sexual identity and I'm gonna wear that around. There's also the concept of having a private sexual identity. And that's saying, I know what my sexual identity is, but it's going to remain private until I'm safe enough and I'm comfortable enough to tell the world. So that language could be really helpful, not only talking about who gets to know this information, it sets a really beautiful set of boundaries to say, this is what my sexual orientation is, and I understand it holistically. At first, I'm giving you a personal example, I thought I was gay because I was attracted to the same gender. And then I realized over time that I was sometimes, in some ways, in some circumstances, attracted to the opposite gender. And then I realized that I was attracted to a whole spectrum of genders. And so I realized I went from identifying as gay to identifying as bi to then eventually identifying as pan. And that evolution was really important for me because now it allows me to articulate who I am and what I experience to those who I trust and who I respect, but it also allows me and my fiance to have really clear language around what my sexuality looks like. The idea of private and public identity will also help you as you talk about this really understand Who gets to know, who doesn't know, as I've already said. Another piece of language that really helped me articulate my experiences during my coming out, and still now, is the idea that I may have a sexual orientation and a sexual identity, but those are very different than my cultural identity. And I'm not talking about being a Hispanic Latinx person. I'm talking about kind of the heterosexist world or the queer community. And so, as a bisexual person, it was very easy for my religious family to say, well, then just fall in love with a woman and marry her, and then everything's fine. And what I would come back saying is, but I am culturally gay. And so as a culturally gay person, I don't see myself falling in love with or marrying the opposite gender. So although I am capable of that in my sexual orientation, it does not align with who I am culturally. I've had many clients who identify as bisexual who choose to fall in love with someone of the opposite gender and get married and have great sex and babies and they're very content there, but their cultural identity is not aligned with the queer community, and so the way that they dream of, and if they're following their authenticity, it guides them in a direction than where mine went. And that is completely, it's on a spectrum, so everything is welcome. The other idea here is that all of this language, from sexual orientation to sexual identity to how you align culturally, it all depends on if you're safe enough to come out of the closet. So in this blog, you can see that there is this notion of necessary closets. You might come out to some people and you might stay in the closet with other people because they're toxic or abusive or the rejection is imminent and we haven't put up maybe a support system around you to support you. So some closets are necessary, and I really, really want to acknowledge that, because the cultural narrative might say, well, just come out and everybody has to deal with it, but that might not actually be what's best for you. And so I always help clients identify where are the safe and trustworthy people to whom you can come out with right now, and expand to other areas that might not hold the same kind of respect and safety for you. But when you come out to the unsafe people, you have places where you are safe. So be gentle with yourself, move at the pace that's appropriate for you, because some closets are necessary. There's this idea also of, I came up with this years ago after listening to the way that hundreds of queer people were coming out. I first realized that there's 6 different stages: coming out to ourselves, admitting what is true, coming out to a friend, that's usually the first step many of us take, then there's coming out to a loved one, and then we have to reconcile something I call the self-concept. When I was straight and closeted, I was dreaming about my life in a certain way. I was going to be the macho straight man who married a woman, and I was the provider. And my whole identity was being formed around that image. And then when I came out to myself and other people, I realized in stage 4 that I had to come up with a new self-concept. What would gay Isaac's life look like? And that was a whole season of reimagining my life and then kind of orienting my momentum and my development in that direction. And so that can be a really important phase. So the first 4 phases, they're all done internally. They're cognitive recognitions, they're verbal statements. It's a way of aligning who we are as an internal process or a verbal statement, which is very different than stage 5. Stage 5 is not a verbal declaration, it's a physical action. Stage 5 is not only saying that we're queer, it's now demonstrating our queerness, which is a whole nother layer of coming out. For me, it was one thing to say, Mom, I'm gay. It was another thing to let her see me hold hands with my fiance, Joe, to let her see me kiss him on the forehead, to let her see us cuddling. And that was a very, very different type of coming out that required a new layer of courage. So I just want you to be prepared, because in this stage, as you're coming out to a spouse or watching your spouse come out to you, it's oftentimes a verbal statement, and then what does it look like to see that queerness being demonstrated? And of course, that will vary on what path that you take within your relationship. So just want to call that out. The sixth stage, it might not be necessarily applicable here, but hopefully this information is helpful. When we're in the closet, we are in the closet with our desires. No one potentially gets to see my desire to feel sexy, my desire to be desired, my desire to be intelligent and flamboyant, or whatever those desires are, whatever feels authentic, can often live very sequestered and tucked away with us in the closet. And sometimes when we come out of the closet, we leave our desires in there. And so stage six is normally about how do I go back in there and reclaim my desires so that I could live as a whole, authentic, integrated being. Because oftentimes what happens, and this might happen in your coming out, but we come out and we say, what is the socially appropriate version of Isaac as a gay person that I want to present to you? And the problem with that is that it only allows people to bond to the curated persona that we're creating, which can leave us behind the persona really, really lonely. So it's really important during the coming out process to make sure that we're bringing our desires with us, so that way when our spouse gets to know who we are as this new queer person, they're really getting to know the authentic version, not just the shiny, polished version that we think will create safety. At I Am Clinic, we have a ton of resources. We have several other blogs. We have Queer Relationships, which is our podcast you can find on Apple Podcasts or anywhere you find your podcasts. And of course, we have all of the therapists and life coaches on staff, so that way we can help you no matter where you're at in the world. So if you find yourself struggling with a coming out spouse, or if you find yourself challenged by coming out, give us a ring. We're always here to help. You can find us at iamclinic.org.